easily 10 times more hype for this episode after how last episode ended. Easily. What's up, Dapper Squad? It's your boy Darius, back at it again with Black Clover, episode 9. Last episode, we had our first mission. I mean, technically, yeah, it is for our, but it's not really their fault. It's Noelle's and Asta's first mission caused by Magna and Yami. They lost at poker, so they have to go for Saussy, who's the mayor of, I forgot the village's name. They have to go get rid of the fire boars or the fire pigs. And while they're on their way there, on top of the awesome broom called Crazy Cyclone, some ice mages, some other people came and fucked some shit up, and they're looking for a magic stone. I'm so curious, so intrigued. Remember, if you guys want to support me and get early access and full length to all the current shows I'm watching, all the shows I've watched in the past, and all the shows I've ever done, check out that Patreon down below. That link is always available to you. If you guys do want to support and Patreon's not really your thing, if you guys could leave a like and a comment down below, that really helps push my name out there in the algorithm, makes YouTube really like me a lot more, so I'd really appreciate it a lot, a lot. Don't forget to follow me on Twitch and on Twitter for the updates and the live streams, and then check out that Discord if you guys ever want to chat with us or ask me any questions at the end of the episode. There is a section on there for that. Let's hop into this. Black Clover, episode 9. Yeah, it is definitely using fire magic. If I seen that though, I'd be terrified. But I wonder if this is like Naruto, where certain elements have an advantage on other ones. Like, would water beat fire in this situation? Makes sense. Okay, buddy. He's over here carrying like 4 of them. Okay, Asta. And I remember he mentioned he's from a village in the boonies, so that's just past here. So of course you knew the mayor. Makes sense. Look at a young Magna. His hair is so much shorter. He's such a delinquent. Look at his hooligan ass. Ooh, whipped out his own grim. Ooh, 7 swords magic, whatever that shit is. That looks so dangerous. Imagine getting an ass whooping in the middle of square in public. Like a Oh, that's hilarious. So he can just create weapon? Oh! Is he a specialist on creation magic? Because he can create a glove, bow and arrow, swords? I love this old man. That's awesome. Oh, that's cool. They're having their own little duels, you know? Because he had his own dreams and goals back in his day. I love somebody like Saussy, where you've known him since you were a kid, and he's half the reason you've gotten better as a person and bigger in the world, and you come back to still be friends with him. I love those kind of characters, you know? He said, there's no way that's happening. I'm somebody from the boonies, you know? Commoner, yeah. Shout out to Magna, bro. Yeah, shout out to Magna, shout out to Saussy, bro. These guys are dope. Just immediately cut the heartwarming music. Oh, that's hilarious. Yeah. All because of him. I love that. And that's where you guys, that's cool. That's where you guys played poker and lost. That's how it happens, though. I love that relationship. Ooh, be lost in the mist is what that ice guy said. That literally is like a jutsu from Naruto. Village mist covering jutsu. Ooh, we do have an anti-magic sword. That is awesome. I forgot about that. That is true. Damn it. Ora. What is this, JoJo's? Ora. Ooh, all the villagers are in the square. I'm guessing they rounded them all up together so they could look for the stone slash get whoever has the stone. Oh, ooh. This is not looking good. I was about to say, if anyone's going to get rid of ice, explosive scatter shot. That is such a cool magic. What do you call them? Because in Naruto, real quick, guys, they're called jutsus. Do you call them abilities, magical abilities, or spells? What are they called here? Was that a cool spell? Just so I don't sound stupid. I really would love to know. There's no way. There's no way, bro. Of course, he say he's grandson Nick, man. All right, I was just talking about how much I love Sehi, bro. R.I.P., bro. Fuck. This guy's like Saussy from Naruto. 10 seconds. Uh-oh. Okay. Man, I'm pissed, bro. I love old, nice characters. That is a huge ice attack. No hesitation. Not even worried. That's a big ice attack. Oh my god. Asta. Look at them. That's me. Just jaw dropped. Come on. Hell yeah. Hell yeah. That's not the end, right? It's not the end. Good. Halfway through. Hell yeah. From Diamond or Barbarians here to trash the Barbarians or Spies? Who are these guys? Mist Magic Whirlpool of Illusory Mist. Lord Heath. Oh. And is that their saying? Be lost in the mist? But they don't know he has an anti-magic sword. Yeah. Oh, okay, I'm definitely going back to watch this later. I'm not pausing it right now, but I'm definitely going back to pause this later. I mean, to any human people like you. Yeah, like, that's because you're not a human person. You're a dickhead. Yeah. It's got it. I love it. Nash is so funny. Or how I grew up. Come on, bro. You really gonna talk like that to Asta? These are his people. Endless ice cage. A compound magic, so you can compound them. Interesting. That's interesting. So they're not really able to stop their own ice. They can just use another spell to dissolve it. Interesting. This is why it's called Endless Ice Cage. It's just never ending. Okay. Yeah, I was about to say, if everyone there is at least Magic Knight level, that guy has to be. I don't know if he's squad captain, but he's definitely higher. Yeah, you're not wrong there. That might be thumbnail. That looks fucking good. And yet, these people are... I'm saying, they're not only amazing, but, you know, they're sticking their necks out. Don't do that, Noelle. Yeah, we gotta break her out of this mentality. I understand why she would think like that, but nah. Look at that little girl's face. I'm saying, you're gonna run away from her? Come on, Noelle. Hell yeah. I got some chills on the back of my neck, I can't lie. A new spell? So it's called a spell. The show answered it for me. This music combined with whatever the fuck Noelle is doing here is actually pretty damn awesome. Ice is not gonna do anything to water. It's either gonna stop it, melt it. Oh, the ending's coming. That's gotta be the thumbnail right there. Come on. All right, well, that was a fantastic episode, I won't lie. I loved a little bit of the lore drop we got. I love the commitment between all of our characters to be able to protect these people, especially the perspective switches we got of Asta, who grew up like these people, so they need to do it. Same thing with Magna versus Noelle, who's like, I really technically should be thinking like the other guys, you know, I should be like classist. Thanks you guys for letting me know that, by the way, classist. Appreciate y'all, I really do. But once she saw the actual little girl, there's no running away from that. You have to literally have no heart. Like, it must have been out of your body to run away from her. So I completely agree with her decision. That emotional, I don't want to say turn right there, but that emotional gut punch she had from that girl gave her a new spell to protect these people, which is awesome. I have a question. I had a question in the episode. I asked them if there were abilities or spells. They're called spells, which is awesome. Is it something like that that just happens as something goes down? No spoilers for Hunter x Hunter, of course, but in Hunter x Hunter, power base is at least somewhat similar. Like, that can happen due to emotion, due to how you're feeling in a certain moment. A power can develop. Is it similar to that, where a power can develop? Like, not a power, but a spell? Like, you're like, fuck, man, I really wish I could heat up that fucking leftover pizza over there. Oh, shit, I got a leftover pizza heat up spell that just popped up out of nowhere. Give me some non-spoilery, even if it's spoilery, don't tell me at all. Just tell me I have to wait. But if you can, give me some non-spoilery. Is it? But I assume that would be spoilery to ask if it's like emotional or if it's skill tied. I mean, we know it's blood tied, magical powers related to family, genetic stuff like that. I just want to know more. I'm sure I'll get it. I don't know. I'm just being impatient. But I did go back and write down the kingdoms as best as I could. So, and I love the imagery in this, how, you know, how it's called like upper class, middle class, lower class in terms of classes and societies, in terms of the United States at least. But I love how in this show, physically, they're on top of you. Like, the nobility literally looks down on you because they live in like a fucking mountain range. And that's taking it to the extreme, and I love it. But you got, and this is particularly the Spade Kingdom, it said. So maybe there's other kingdoms where it's different. I'm not sure. I can't wait to learn. But in the Spade Kingdom, we have the Noble Realm, then the Common Realm, then the Forsaken Realm, which is where like the boonies and the commoners live. Well, not because that's the Common Realm, lower than the commoners. But then it branches off to the two side ones. We have the Heart and then the Diamond. Whereas maybe the Barbarians are from the Heart, but Magna was like, who are these guys? They're not Barbarians and they're not spies from the Diamond Kingdom or whatever. So I want to know more about that. I cannot wait. I won't lie. But this guy's name is Lord Heath. I gotta highlight that so I don't lose it in the future and I can come back to it ASAP. No Rocky. His name is Lord Heath. The magic in terms of the ice and the combining. Oh, that's another thing I wanted to ask. I don't know if it's like, maybe it's spoilery as well, but do certain elements beat other ones, like have an advantage over certain ones by a default? You'd assume so. Like, you'd assume water would beat fire and fire would beat ice. But you don't know, because Magna technically wasn't bidding, winning, but it's also a 1v4, his magical powers are drained. So, you know, it's like I'm always curious about that kind of stuff, because that played a heavy part later on in Naruto down the line, you know? So I'm always curious. Other than that, I think that's pretty much it for this episode. Let me check, oh, if you guys heard that was another video I had rendering. Let me check the Discord to see if there's any Q&As over here for Black Clover. If you guys ever want to ask me anything, now is going to be the time. End of episodes are where I answer it. Just pop on over there, ask me what you want. There seems to be nothing, so this was a fantastic episode. Thank you to the sponsor. Always appreciate you, Plebma. All the support you've been given. Oh so grateful. Oh so appreciative. I really am. Remember, guys, if you guys want early access, full length, don't want to wait this bunch, check out that Patreon down below. Make sure to like this video if you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what you thought down below, of course. And don't forget to check that Twitch and that Twitter for the updates and the live stream, guys. I appreciate you. I'll catch you in this next episode. Peace out, Dapper Squad.